Hello, everyone. Good morning, and welcome to our new Friday Lifestyle Hacks webinar. And this webinar is for you. We are looking at how do we help you to incorporate some of the building materials or practices that you would need in order to enhance your tele-youth and tele-mega rejuvenation process. And so with me is Dr. Chris. Hello, Dr. Chris.
Good morning, Dr. Tina, and good morning, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us. We're really excited about presenting this new addition to our presentations and really help you expand your experience in health and well-being. So Dr. Tina, why don't we get started?
Sure. You know, it's very, very possible to age backwards. In other words, it is very possible, and many of us are doing this, where the chronological clock is moving forward and our biological clock is moving backwards. And that means that we are gaining health, vitality, and wellness. And, you know, some of us, like Dr. Chris and I know, we take for granted some of the other supplements or some of the other practices that we incorporate on a daily basis. And I will tell you, I have to laugh with this one, Dr. Chris, as I was looking at my vitamin C notes, because that's going to be one of our topics today. We'll start with vitamin C, and then we're going to jump into vitamin D3 and K2 after we open it up for a few questions or comments. I started to increase my vitamin C. I don't know about you, but it was like, ooh, you know, I'm probably in need of some more of this. So
exactly. Anyway,
yeah. Jumping into vitamin C. Vitamin C is a water soluble vitamin, and it's so important for many things. First of all, the formation of collagen. You know, we need to have collagen, not only the glue that holds all of our cells together, but our skin. And our skin is the only suit that we're going to wear for a lifetime. So when we're looking at vitamin C, there are even topical forms of vitamin C, you know, in the esthetician skincare world, because vitamin C is so important for the formation of collagen. It's also important for iron absorption, proper immunity, wound healing, the maintenance of cartilage, bones, and teeth. It's an incredible antioxidant. It protects our cells against the effects of free radicals. And free radicals are formed, you know, even when we just live our normal daily life, when we eat food. It also helps with neurotransmitters. So vitamin C is very important. It helps to also make us happy with those neurotransmitters. And our body doesn't make it. We have to have a daily intake of vitamin C. Dr. Chris, you want to add some things there?
I do. It's so important from the standpoint, just as you said, because we don't make it, we have to supplement it. We have to get it. And fortunately, it's in all the good foods, you know, the vegetables, the fruits. There, we could just list so many things where it's available. So it's important to get it in your foods and also supplement a little extra. And it comes in different forms, and we'd like to talk about those different forms. You get it primarily vitamin C. It's more common scientific term is ascorbic acid. But in nature, it comes as a complex. It always has all the other what we refer to as bioflavonoids, and like, you know, quercetin and other bioflavonoids that come with it. So this is why we recommend it more in its natural form. And I know, Dr. Tina, you really like the amla C, and that's a good broad spectrum natural form of vitamin C, and the body recognizes it, absorbs it nicely through the science that we have today. We've learned to encapsulate it within a fat, meaning a liposomal vitamin C, which helps it to absorb more, because, you know, vitamin C, if you take too much at one time, because it of its acidic form, it can create loose stools. You know, so oftentimes we tell people, if you need extra vitamin C for a certain condition, like a cold or flu, you take it to bowel tolerance. And what's interesting, the body will use it according to what it needs. So on a daily basis, you could take maybe 1-2,000 milligrams, and that'll be your bowel tolerance. But if you're under the weather and you have this weakened condition of a cold or a flu, you'll find you could take 5 grams of vitamin C, and you won't have loose stools. So it shows you the wisdom of the body. It knows when when you're providing something that it needs, it knows how to use it, and it takes it and uses it efficiently. So it's really such an important vitamin to understand and how to work with it. Dr. Tina, back to you.
Yes, you know, you mentioned ascorbic acid. That's derived from citrus. When we're looking at amla, that's AMLA. Usually that's from an Indian gooseberry. And why I like that one is because it also helps quite a bit with gut issues. We've heard the term leaky gut, digestion issues. And so it's a great antifungal and antibacterial as well. With the lipoform, it's in a phospholipid layer, meaning it's bioavailable, maximum absorption, and you don't have to rely on the body's own transport system. So it becomes very therapeutic. Some of the key things when you're looking at those three different forms of vitamin C, it's great to rotate them. You know, I will take turns with them. One time I will be working with the lipospheric, I'll use a bottle of that. Then I'll jump over to the amla. And then the ascorbic acid is fantastic for traveling because you can get that in, you know, packets like emergency. And if I'm on an airplane, I open those up. You know, I don't like those biofuels being recycled back into the cabin, and so those, the extra vitamin C while I'm traveling in my water is fantastic. I want to talk about the foods that you mentioned, Dr. Chris. Foods are very high in vitamin C, always recommending organic, but there are a lot of different diets out there today. There's the keto diet, there's this diet, there's that diet. And I'm finding that most people are not getting their fruits and vegetables. So citrus is always a great one. Remember, kiwi is part of that citrus group. So get your citrus in, bell peppers, strawberries, tomatoes, cruciferous vegetables, the broccoli, the Brussels sprouts, the cabbage, the cauliflower, white potatoes, and even honey has a little bit of vitamin C in it as well. And then keep in mind, people that are low in vitamin C, they feel fatigue and they can become irritable and they can have excessive weight loss. They can feel the weakness. There's obviously scurvy that we've heard of with the low vitamin C. And then there's people that bruise easily, or they have bumpy skin or dry skin or slow wound healing or weak bones or painful swollen joints or bleeding gums and tooth loss. You may be deficient in vitamin C. Now, this is an incredible nutrient that works very synergistically with your telo-youth and your telomega to help rejuvenate the body. So vitamin C is going to be on the top of our list for you to incorporate, and you take it with your food. Primarily with your food is best. Usually better to take it, you know, before dinner, not too late at night. And some of the things that also deplete us quickly with our vitamin C is alcohol, processed foods, eating those processed foods and excess sugar, smoking, and then obviously the diet lacking your fruits and vegetables. So,
Dr. Tina, I'd just like to add, you brought up such a great point on how it just is so synergistic with TeleYouth and TeleOmega, because we all know that TeleYouth activates our stem cells. And the vitamin C improves the quality of those stem cells. So now you have stem cells that really function at their optimal level with the right amounts of vitamin C, and then activating them, you know, the release and the activation through the telouth. And the other thing that plays, vitamin C plays a key role, is that it's reactivating your anti-inflammatory genes. So it works throughout the body to help the body reduce inflammation, no matter where it's at. And it works with tumor suppressor genes. So remember, our genes are there just dormant, waiting to be activated according to its environment. And when you add this vitamin C into the environment, you're facilitating the anti-inflammatory response in the body and facilitating the tumor suppressor response to the body. So you can see how it's just so powerful as a systemic nutrient and works so well with what the telouth is doing and the teleomega on a whole nother level. So they complement each other beautifully. So yes, Dr. Tina, that's all I had.
Great. And I just want to, just a little reminder here that there are two things primarily that will inhibit our stem cell activity. One is excessive or chronic inflammation, and also excessive stress hormones. So vitamin C along with your telouth, again, is so synergistic to bring down that inflammation and enhance that stem cell system for recovery and repair. Okay. And why don't we go ahead and open it up for any comments or questions? On vitamin C, jump on in. We'll save other comments or questions for at the end of the webinar. But if you have any specific questions regarding vitamin C, unmute your line, jump on in.
I have a question.
Paula, sure. Hello.
Hi. Earlier in your presentation, you mentioned that you switch back and forth. I only got the Alma. What other one did you say you switch back and forth to?
There are three of them that I rotate. One is just going to be a normal ascorbic acid, and that's going to be in a lot of the supplementation that is out there. I tend to grab the emergency packets that have the, you know, you tear them open, it's a powder form, and you can put that into your water and shake it up and drink it, or even add it to a smoothie to give you that extra boost of vitamin C. AMLA, A-M-L-A, is a food source. And I like that food source because of all the bioflavonoids that are complementing it. It has the cofactors in there. And so I use an AMLA C. Also helps with gut issues, leaky gut. It's an antifungal, antibacterial. So, and it's made from typically from Indian gooseberry. And then the third one is lipospheric. And that is in a fat, it's like encapsulated in a phospholipid. That's a, should be a common word that you all hear us talk about with the phospholipid layer. So it's encapsulated in this phospholipid to make it through the digestion tract a little bit more. And it makes it more bioavailable to go into the cells. It tends to be very therapeutic. So you might be able to take more of the ascorbic acid and less of the lipo. And everybody is going to be different.
More of the lipo.
More of the lipo, yes. Thank you. More of the lipo, less of the ascorbic.
You got it.
Yeah, thank you. And so that will give, you know, but everybody's going to be a little bit different. And we all, you know, for instance, up here in the north, we don't get really good fruits and vegetables, especially in the wintertime, you know, so you might want to take extra vitamin C during the winter.
Really important.
Yeah. Try to get those good fruits and vegetables in.
And Paula, if you're looking for the food form, you know, Dr. Chi and I recommend the AMLA C, but also it comes as acerola cherry form. So that's another food form, because the acerola cherries are high in vitamin C, and they find a way to concentrate it and provide it as a supplement. So those are two ways to get it in the natural food form. from the tablet or the powder
in the accelerator, you know, which one do you think you get more vial availability?
You know, you everyone's going to be a little bit different. I think that the food, the most effective is going to be the food form or the lipospirit. Okay. The last one I would choose would be the ascorbic acid.
Correct. I agree. Okay. Anyone else with a comment or question before we move on? Because we've got another great vitamin to discuss about with our immune system, especially.
Thank you so much for sharing about the vitamin C. No wonder why I got, you know, usually I got really get bruised easily. I was always wondering why. Then today I know that, oh, it was lack of vitamin C. So I think I should take more than that. Right.
Exactly, yeah. Rachel. It builds the tissue integrity. It's part of the collagen and the tissue integrity of all your vessels and throughout your body.
I see. All right.
You know, and remember, when we have excessive stress, it's like putting our foot on the gas pedal and we become very depleted, and we break down collagen 10 times faster when we are in that stress mode. And, you know, Tele-Youth helps to mediate the stress. In other words, bring the stress hormones into balance. And the vitamin C is a beautiful cofactor with our Tele-Youth to help form collagen. So it's so synergistic with what we teach with our formulas.
All right.
I see. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, Gina, Dr. Chris, want to go to the next one?
Yes, go for it.
All right. Okay, so let's talk about vitamin D and K2. And vitamin D is a fat soluble vitamin, but it's also known as a hormone, right? And K2, it's great to take those together, right? If you're going to supplement. And K2 prevents arterial calcification. In other words, both of these together promotes calcium and phosphorus absorption, helps us with bone growth, reduces inflammation, modulates cell growth processes. That's very important when we're talking about cancers and other diseases. It helps with neuromuscular and immune function as well. And then K2 is also very important to help with blood clotting. But if you are in something like warfarin, you know, you need to stay away from K2. So Dr. Chris, what would you like to add before we jump into the other parts of this incredible nutrient?
I love the diversity, because most often, you know, growing up, you hear about vitamin D for strong and healthy bones. But like you said, it plays a key role in our endocrine system. It's a hormone in its own right. And it facilitates healthy heart, cardiovascular function. It has a key role, very, very key role in the immune system. So we find that it helps regulate the epigenome. Remember, our genes are not who we are as much as our epigenome that expresses our genes. And vitamin D plays a key role in the expression of hundreds of our genes in a very healthy way. So when you're deficient in vitamin D, you're automatically accelerating your aging process. So when you get back to healthy levels of vitamin D and you take your Tele-Youth and Tele-Omega, now you have the opportunity to reverse the biological clock. So you take your vitamin D to, you know, slow things down from degeneration, build back the healthy tissue integrity, get all the systems communicating and coordinated. And this is why, you know, we're going to be talking more down the road here about our circadian cycles and sunlight. But, you know, vitamin D is the sunshine vitamin, and we make it by its, you know, by exposing our skin to the sun. And so many of us are afraid of that solar exposure because of how we've been commercially programmed to be afraid of the sun. So that exposure in the afternoon to get the good, healthy sun rays. You know, and if you haven't been exposed to the sun a lot, you start slow and you build up your solar callus, you build up your solar tolerance. And this is how you're going to make your vitamin D naturally. And until you get up to those healthy levels, we strongly recommend that you supplement it. So it's important to test for your vitamin D levels. And even if you're not going to be testing, we can almost tell you that it's going to be deficient unless you're out there in the sun or you're taking the vitamin D foods, the things like all the good seafoods. You find it in salmon and sardines and beef liver, egg yolk, cod liver oil is loaded, you know, mackerel, trout. These are all the good foods that give us our vitamin D and a form that we can really absorb and take advantage of. So these are things that so many of us don't do and ignore. And this is why we want to really emphasize not just the nutrient itself, but how to get it naturally in your diet and how to have a lifestyle that fortifies that. So here's a time, we're in the summer months. You know, summer just started this week, and boy, take advantage of the healthy rays. Get that red light in the morning to activate your circadian cycle, and get that, you know, the rays in the afternoon to build up your solar callus and make that vitamin D inside your body, inside the tissue. Dr. Tina.
Yes, I just want to also touch, you know, all of the animal-based foods pretty much are going to assist you with your vitamin D levels. So who's deficient? You know, so many people, like you mentioned, are deficient. If you're vegan or ovo-vegetarian, if you have that limited exposure to sunlight, if you have milk allergies or you're lactose intolerant, you could be deficient. Breastfed infants, if infants are breastfed too long and they don't get the vitamin D, they typically don't get enough from mom, or they need to have some kind of a supplementation. Older adults, we see our seniors, because they're indoors so much, they're having vitamin D challenges. And people with dark skin, the darker your skin, the more sun exposure you need, because you have a natural blocking to getting the good D3 rays into your system. If you have fat absorption issues, you may have challenges with vitamin D3. If you've had a gastric bypass surgery, or if you're considered obese, there's that small intestine that is where the vitamin D gets absorbed into the body when you're ingesting it. And that can cause vitamin D3 deficiency. So number one, out in the sun at the right time for longer periods, getting your body exposed is going to help you naturally. How do you know if you are deficient? You're going to have fatigue. You're not going to sleep well, bone pain, depression, sadness, hair loss, weak muscles, loss of appetite. You easily get sick and you have increased belly fat. And Dr. Chris, you mentioned a couple of other areas, like, for instance, cardiovascular issues, the immune system issues, weak bones, teeth, rickets in children. But you can get tested for this. And if you're a doctor, I find this so fascinating that a lot of doctors, when you go to the medical system and you ask them, I want to get my D3 levels tested, many of them refuse to do some of those tests. And so you can order a test at home and just prick your finger, put a drop of blood on a cardboard sheet and send that in. And there's a company called Everlywell, EverlyWell. You can order a kit and have just, I think it's less than $100 to get it in and have your vitamin D and inflammation tested. So, and if you're low in your vitamin D3, K2, just remember, it can take time to build that up. It's not like your body is going to, if you start supplementing, you're all of a sudden within 2 or 3 days going to be at the levels that your body requires. Because when you start to supplement with it, there are absorption, could be absorption challenges, but also getting your body to hold on to it and use it and make sure it's bioavailable can be challenging. So it'll take about 3 to 4 months. And then you can retest yourself if you feel like you need to. When do you take it? Some people take it with food. There are no real studies that say what is the most important. I've actually had some of my clients take up to 20,000 international units before bedtime who are very, very deficient, and it actually helps them with sleep. So taking it with their omegas at night when they go to bed, or their telomega. So all of these, hopefully these different things can help you to incorporate vitamin D into your diet and making sure, get your baseline test done if you're experiencing any of those symptoms as well. Dr. Chris, do you have anything to add?
Oh, great. Yeah, Dr. Tina, I'd just like to just reemphasize, you know, we've run our time out here. And please take advantage of these rejuvenation lifestyle seminars, because I can assure you that, you know, when you're out there and have a problem with your health, and you need to understand that we need to learn to take better care of ourselves, because the medical system is dramatically changing. First of all, all the hospitals and the urgent care centers are all understaffed. They're overworked. And so many have just started to really get out of this, system and practicing medicine because of the challenging times. And even if you do get to see a doctor, you have a very limited time with that doctor, and they practice formula medicine, meaning one size fits all. They don't look at you as an individual. So it's so important to understand these little wonderful tidbits of lifestyle and the opportunity to really enhance your own health and well-being and take full responsibility for it. And you'll just really be happy that you did. And we're just so glad to be able to present this information.